Good morning to everyone. I welcome you all class 4, that is EVS subject, that is learn mapping and know directions. Yes, this is the lesson number 12. Yes, students, we will discuss about this today. Okay, so what we will learn from this lesson, we will learn to locate the directions by using the symbols. So how we will be using the symbols and how we will be show the directions, so which places in which direction is there. Yes, so we will be see now. Yes, so before going to this lesson, first we will be understanding, see here the what it is we will understanding now. So north, east, south, west. Yes, so these are the directions. First we will be understanding directions now. So north, south, west, east, it means east, west. So you know that is okay. Here we can understanding here. So in between of north and south, sorry, in between of north and east, northeast, south and east, southeast. Then next, south and west, southwest, north and west, northwest. Yes, so we will be learn today. So here we can understanding from, so east. So in this east side, so we will be studying here. So east, west, north, south. So east is here, in the east sun rises. Yes, sun rises in the east. sunset. So in this side, sun set. Yes. So we can understanding sunrise from east here. So sunrise in the west. Yes. So here we can understanding. So locate the directions by using a local symbols and also learn the basic skills of drawing maps and draw a map using a different symbols. So which are the symbols we are using to draw different maps? Yes. So mapping means, what is the mapping means? So mapping means is here. So it is a process of making map. So mapping means it is the process of making map. Yes. So and also, what is the meaning of direction? Direction is the path that must be taken to reach a specific place. Yes, so direction is the path that must be taken to reach a specific what place. So this is the mapping and the meaning of directions. Yes, so here what are the uses of mapping? Yes, you see, to understand the roads and subways at a new places. We can understanding the roads and subways of the new places. So in which place, wherever we are going to a new place, we don't know where it is, in which place it is, we don't know. So we are using map. Yes, so you can see in the map, it can be showing that. And to calculate the distance between the two places, and also it is using to calculate the distance between the two places. Here two places means, here we can understanding from here, from Bangalore to Mangalore, how much kilometer is there. So we can be using that map. Yes, so to find out the kilometers. And to know the other path of the same place, to know the other path, where means a different path. So we can know the different path of other place. And also to know the shortest path, and also we can knowing the shortest, so which is the shortest path is there, no? So we can know the what it is, shortest path also. And we can get information about mountains, valley, river, any things which may come on the way. Yes, we know also, we can get information about mountains, valley, river, any things which may come on the way, which are the places it will be come on the way. Yes. And so these all are the things using of mapping. What are the using of map? And so now we will studying here the direction of the map. So what are the things, what are the uses of direction of map? So direction helps to the locate the places. It helps to locate the places. And the direction is a specific way we can go to get from one place to as a one location to the next location. So these all are the, we can study the using of mapping and also the uses of direction. Yes. So now we will be continue this one. Yes, see here. So now we will be know about the directions. Yes, students, they can be given here in your textbook. So here see, know something about mapping and look at the map given below. So there is a big banyan tree in the middle of the village and identify it. Yes, so here see, they can be given here one of the what it is mapping. Yes, so the big banyan tree is middle in the village. So surrounding of these, so many things are there, so it's a village panchayat is there, veterinary hospital is there, school is there, then fair price shop is there, library, park, hospital, then well, yeah, next post office is there. So I hear pond is there. Yes, so many places are there surrounding of the banyan tree. Yes, so now we will be studying. So which of the places it will be comes in the, in which directions, now we will be seeing. Okay, so first one they can be given here pond. So where it comes pond? So north east. See here northeast, where it comes here? So northeast. So here pond. Yes, so that is the pond. Yes, we will mention here, this is the pond. Okay, so next they can be given here. So write the directions of the given places with the reference to the banyan tree. We will be reference and we will be find out. So which are the places in which directions are there. Yes, so next one, library. Library is in the, where it is library? Yes, in the west side is there. So library, we'll write here library. So okay, this is a library. Yes, so it is in the west side is there. So next one, that is a school. School is there in between here. So south and east. So I'll draw here. So this is the school. Yes, so this is the school. Yes, so this is the school. So next they can given here post office. So where it is the post office? Post office there. Post office there here. Northeast. So northeast. Post office here. I'll write post office. Okay, so this in the northeast side. Okay, so next one, park. They can be mentioned here. Park, where it is park? Yes, park in the west side. Here also it comes. Okay, park. So I'll draw a park here. Some of the trees are there here. So it is a park. Yes, okay. Next one, they can mention a temple. Temple, where it is? Temple in the northwest. Sorry, temple in the north. So here temple is there. So okay, so this is a temple. So temple. So this is a temple. Next they can given here park, temple. Okay, fair price shop is there in the southwest here. Fair price shop. Okay, yes. So next one, veterinary hospital. Where it is veterinary hospital? So veterinary hospital in east side. So here veterinary hospital. hospital. Okay, so the next one, so they can given here mosque, so that is the south east, so that is where it is south east, that is mosque, that is here it comes. Okay, so south east. So mosque. The next one, church. Church, where it is church here? Church in south east. South east. Here also it comes south east. That is church. Okay. Yes. So next one, hospital. So hospital north. North side it comes here. Hospital. Hospital. Okay. So it is hospital. Next it comes as here well. Well it comes as here northwest. So it comes here north well. Yes students, you can understanding here. So which are the places comes in a which directions? Yes, see here. So here north, south, east and west. Yes, we can understanding here. Sunrise from east, here sunrise in the east, sunrise sunset in the west. Okay, so here in the north side, which are the places is there? Hospital is there, then pond is there, post office is there. Yes, so these all are in north and east, in between north and east here. Okay, so here in the east and south. Okay, in east directions, so in which are there in the south directions. Church is there in the southeast. Mosque is there in the east direction. Veterinary hospital is there in the, and also school is there in the east, southeast direction. Okay, so and here see in the west and south, southwest direction in which are there here. Fair Price shop is there and even park is there and also library is there. Yes, so and here northwest direction, temple is there and well is there. So these all are the things, all are the places we can understanding. So which are the places comes in which directions? Yes, yes students. Next they can given here. So in your house is shown in the picture. So given below, write the things around your house according to the directions. Yes, so they can given in, already wrote here in our house surrounding which are the things are there. Here see, so north, even your house north side, west side, east side and south side, even northwest, north, south east, south west and northeast. So which are the places it will be comes in the surrounding of in your house and in which direction which is there. So I'll write here in the north side, in our house north side hospital is there and south side market is there, then next east side school is there and west side park is there. Like next it is northeast side post office is there, then southeast side mosque is there, then next southwest side library is there, northwest side temple is there. So okay, so it is in our house surrounding, in the direction of in our house. Okay, yes, write the things around your school according to the directions. Yes, in your school according to the direction, east side what is there, west what is there, south what is there, in the north what is there. So you will be writing this fill in. Okay, so fill this blanks. So here observe the map of Karnataka in your school. Write the directions of the place given with a reference to the state. Yes, so here in the state, it means in mapping of Karnataka map, if you can be see the Karnataka map, so we can see here Arabian Sea, in which side it comes? It comes in the west side. Yes, so next one, Andhra Pradesh east, then Maharashtra north, then Kerala south. Like we will be finding which are the places comes in which directions. Yes, okay. See here, they can given here. Yasmin of 4th standard has learned to draw a simple map her classroom and listen, that means listen to her. See here, Yasmin, my teacher asked me to measure the length and breadth of my classroom with my footsteps. So when I did so, I found that द लेंथ ऑफ द रूम दैट इज हियर 12 फुट स्टेप्स एंड ब्रेथ ऑफ द रूम इज 10 फुट स्टेप्स. यस सो माय टीचर टोल्ड मी दैट माय 2 फुट स्टेप्स आर इक्वल टू 1 मीटर. So here the footsteps of the difference from here the person to person someone one who put a steps maybe a 3/4 meter. Know the length of your footsteps. So measure your room by placing your footsteps and record it. So I will tell you how to draw a same on a sheet of a paper. So it means so and let us imagine that the length of the room and measured it's a 12 foot steps and breadth is 10 foot steps. Yes students, so Yasmin is one of the students, so his teacher is tell to him to measure the classroom length in a foot steps. So here he measuring the length of the classroom step and also width of the classroom steps. So they can tell to him, so what they can tell to him to measuring here, so 2 foot steps are equal to 1 foot. Yes, they are measuring 2 foot steps are equal to 1. 2 foot steps are equal to 1 foot. So they are tell to them. Yes, see here, they can be the teacher is tell to him. So 2 foot step is equal to 1 foot. They are measuring. So totally the classroom width and length is 12 foot steps and breadth is 10 foot steps. Yes so here see, so if your two steps are equal to 1 meter, here 12 feet is equal to 6 meter. So it means two foot steps is equal to 1 meter. Okay, so like here how many foot steps are there here? 12 feet is equal to 16 meter. Okay, so like here 12 feet is equal to 6 meter. So here that means the length of the room is total, the length of the room is 6 meters and the breadth of the room is 5 meters. Yes, understood this one? Okay, see here, if we can be convert 1 meter into a 1 centimeter on a scale, 6 meter is equal to 6 centimeter because we will be converting 1 meter into 1 centimeter. Yes, 6 meter is equal to 6 centimeter and 5 meter is equal to 5 centimeter. Okay, 5 centimeter. Yes, so they can given here one of the measurement on a sheet paper. So here 6 centimeter length and 5 centimeter breadth. Okay, so this is the outside mapping. Now you see, so now you have to identify the things to calculate the exact position of the things. Draw a line of 1 centimeter distance as shown in the map given here. So here 1 centimeter distance will be draw a line. So how many lines are there here? 6 lines. Yes, so here 1 to 6 lines. So 1 centimeter will be maintain a gap. Okay, see, now give a number to each of the following square. Give a numbers for length and the length and letters for breadth. Yes, see here. So here length they can be mentioned here, numbers, and breadth they can be mentioned here, letters A, B, C, D, E they can be mentioned here. So then identify the things of the classroom in the squares according to their position. One example they can be given here. So this is the example where it is in the position here. See, in the D place door is there. In here fifth place, that is in the length here, in the fifth foot here, that is table is there. Here in the third chair is there. Here window is there. Here benches are there in a E. So they can identify squares on the map in which the things are situated in a breadth side and also in the length side. Door is in the A, so it is in a breadth side A. Okay, and length is, so it is length is in the steps where it is in the length in the first column. Okay, so first column. So window is C. So window is in a C column in this side in a breadth and a length. So they can be mentioned here and length 1, breadth C. Okay, so likewise they can be mentioned here. So you are also do like the same map. Sketch the map of the classroom of your class your school or house measured by you as you learn from Asmin. Identify the things of that room in the map. Okay, so here large area can be represented on a map. So the squares in the map are helpful to find out the exact location of the things. Yes, so the squares in the maps, these are helps to find out the exact location. Yes, so we will be find out the exact location of in that place, which thing is there. So we will be finding. See here, in the center of the main road, there is the Gandhi Circle. If you go towards its east, on the right side, you will see a hotel. Next to this, there is a hostel, then a post office and a school. Next to the school is the taluk office. So it is situated about 20 meters away from the school. So I have measured the distance by my footsteps. So in this year, they can be given as the one of the students, he can be measuring in his footsteps. So how many footsteps is near of circle? So it means that is the center of the circle, near of the what it is, hotel and hostel, in which direction these are, post office and the school. So these all are he is measuring on footsteps. So answer has drawn a simple map, the area from here Gandhi Circle to taluk office. So with the help of direction, they can be showing here. See, this is the main road. Okay, so they can circle, where it is circle, Gandhi Circle we will be measuring, hostel, primary school, high school, then hotel, post office, taluk office and also playground. So that can be showing a landmarks. Yes, so they can given here question C, which measurement is used on a map to sketch a west area. So what means, which of the measurements we will be using to sketch? Yes, so here centimeter or inches we will be used to sketch a map. Okay, yes, second one, how can the exact location of the things be represented on a map? So how can we see the things exact location? So that is how we will be representing on the map. Yes, so direction and taking of landmark. Okay, so we will be give an exact location of the things. See, in a square shaped room, a table and four chair how to be arranged? How do you arrange them in the map of the room? How we will be arranging on the map of the room? They can be mentioned here. See, A4, the things they can given here, window, door and table, chairs are there. Okay, so square A4, D1, D4 and A1. So here square B3, all are what, these all, these all are on table and also chairs. Okay, so they can be mentioned here. So next one, draw a simple route map from your house to your school. You can use the following symbols to draw route map: house, temple, mosque, church, school, pond, post office, well and tree. Okay, so we'll be draw a simple map. After drawing the maps, exchange your maps with your friends. Know the route, directions and landmarks to your friend's house from the maps. Route map can be drawn with the help of landmarks and directions. So you will be draw using of landmarks and the directions. You will help to find out the things of the place. Okay. Yes. So in this simple map, a bus route has been shown with the arrow marks. So make a list of the landmarks you see while traveling a bus. See here, they can be given here the picture. So we'll be find out in which direction and which of the things are there, which of the places are there. Here mosque is there and road is there, and here see place is there, houses are there. Yes, so and school is there. So we'll be find out the places. Yes, here see some of the things they can be given here. So all the maps have centimeters or inches as the unit of measurement. Yes, see all the maps having 2 centimeter and inches of the unit of the measurement. Yes, world map is the map of the earth. That world map of the, that is the map of the earth. Okay, so we are using that only, no, earth map. Okay, yes. One can easily understand the physical features, land routes and populated areas with the help of the map. So we will be using of map is what purpose we are using? To understand the physical features and land routes, and also these all populated areas, it is helps to find out the areas. That one map. That is longitude and latitudes, the imaginary lines help to form a grid on the map. So there are different types of maps. For example, physical map, soil map, weather map, train route map. So these are the types of the maps. Okay. So it is believed that the Egyptian kings used to draw a maps to know the reasons of their rule, and the Greeks draw the map of the earth in here. So in the year of 540 before Christ. Okay, so about this is the lesson. Which lesson it is? This is the learn mapping and know the direction. So this lesson is completed. So tomorrow we'll start, that is the new chapter. Thank you for watching.